life is simple. Thank you, Lord, because you have made my mouth as the pen of a ready writer.
Yes.
And thank you, Lord, Holy Ghost, you live big within me and you will teach your people, teach all of us your will today concerning healing.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
And we declare that the devil is under our feet, for greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. We want to thank you, Father, Lord, because this church is a great church.
Amen.
Because we serve a great God.
Amen.
And we are ordained that you called us to do great things for your kingdom.
Amen.
Father, we know that the greatest thing in your heart, oh God, is so real. It's reaching to your reach. Hallelujah. We believe you. And we thank you that, oh God, your people here will be taught. They will rise to the point where we will rise to the place of sonship and begin to execute everything you want us to do. And one of the things you want us to do is going into the world. And Father, Lord, you said, make disciples and preach the gospel and make disciples. He that believeth shall be saved. And Father, in Mark chapter 16, you said, this sign shall follow them that believe. And Father, Lord, we are believers here. Signs must follow us.
Amen.
Not because of who we are, because you said it.
Yes,
and we believe it.
Yes,
amen. That signs and wonders shall follow us.
Yes,
and we declare, Father, this morning, oh God, that we will speak your word with boldness.
Yes,
by you stretching forth your hand to heal the sick.
Amen.
And that signs and wonders will be done in the name
amen.
Of Jesus.
Amen.
And your name will be glorified.
Yes,
in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Everybody said amen.
Amen.
Well, hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. 10 points or 10 reasons why every Christian should stay well and not be sick. And today's 10 number 10.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Today's number 10.
Amen.
And then, I know some of you have been saying, when will this thing end? Well, you know, it's one thing for it to end, it's another thing for you to put it to work.
Yeah.
Because faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God.
Yeah.
But James says, be ye doers. The reason why we teach the word of God like this is so that you will be a doer of the word.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Be ye doers of the word and not the others only deceiving yourselves.
Yes.
Because a lot of people, they come to church, they deceive themselves.
Yeah.
And when things happen, they begin to ask, you know, where is God? Where was God when this happened? I wish you guys had Fred Price last Sunday night on television when he was teaching on a topic called, where was God? You know, people complain, where is God when all this is happening? You never saw him before.
Mm-hmm.
It's after some things begin to happen, you begin to ask, you know, where is God? When we are teaching you the word of God in this church like that, so that you will come to that level where you begin to ask, where is God?
Yeah.
You will know where God is.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
God is in his word.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. You know, let's go through it again, you know, praise God. By now you should know it's like your timetable.
Yeah.
Amen. Let me see. Reason number one.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. Reason number one. God is not the author of sickness.
Amen.
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 God is not the author of sickness. Adam did not know sickness until the fall.
Yeah.
Praise God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So God is not the reason. God is not the author of sickness. Reason number two. Everybody read.
Sickness
is originated by Satan and is propagated by the devil. So you know that now.
Yes.
Amen. Don't live here and then you know, the devil attack your body and you say, praise God, Lord, this is the will of God. You are trying to teach me a lesson.
No,
God does not teach me lessons with sickness.
That's
are you listening to me?
Amen.
Praise God. Amen. God does not teach you spiritual things by making you sick.
No,
that's religion. That's a lie.
Amen.
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 Amen. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And you know, people, you know, it's so funny. Even men of God have preached that from the pulpit. That the reason why this thing is happening to you is because God wants to make you more righteous or more holy or, you know, or more humble.
Yeah.
God don't do that.
Amen.
The Bible, you know, particularly when it comes to humility, the Bible says you humble yourself under the mighty hand of God.
Oh, yeah.
The humbling, you have to take your ear and say, humble yourself before God. Amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Nobody can do that for you.
Amen.
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 You have to humble yourself to open the Bible and read it for yourself. You have to humble yourself to go on your knees to pray.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
You have to humble yourself, hallelujah, when you fail, when you miss it. You have to humble yourself enough to say, Lord, forgive me.
Amen?
Amen? Hallelujah. When you sin against someone, you have to humble yourself to enough to go to that person and say, you know, I repent, I'm sorry. You do the humbling. God cannot humble you.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You do the, if it if he was going to do it, he would have not told you, humble yourself under the mighty hand. He would have told you, I'm going to humble you. Amen. Let something fall on your head.
Yeah.
But God doesn't do that. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God is a good God. Everybody say that.
God is a good God.
Yeah, he's a good God. God is very good. God is a good God. Everything about him is good. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Reason number three. Everybody read.
Hidden is talk and promise is both
testament in every book of the Bible. Hidden is there. So you have to, for you to find out what belongs to you, you have to find that. You have to open the book.
Amen.
Amen. Don't allow that cliche we just say in America. Don't allow that to happen to you. You know what they say in America? They say if you want to hide, they used to say this, if you want to hide something for a black man, put it in a book. Because they, you know, in those days they couldn't read. You know?
They don't read.
Amen. Amen. But the funny thing is not really that now. The whole of America don't read. Amen. We have a president who is trying to make them read. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Read the book for yourself.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. The first some you know, the first book of the Bible is called Genesis. Read it. Amen. And the last one is called Revelation. Amen. If you don't open it, you won't find it. Because if I name some books of the Bible now, like Nahum and Micah and all that, Habakkuk is like, where's that? It's in the Bible. Praise God. Read it. Amen. Reason number four, everybody read.
Healing is
it's in the atonement. Amen.
Amen.
Isaiah 53. That's healing in the atonement. Himself took our infirmities. By his stripes we are healed.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Everything Jesus did, he was part of what he did was our healing.
Yeah.
And that's why we have some, you know, that's why we have some 103 in the Bible. Bless the Lord of my soul. And all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord of my soul and forget not all his benefits. Is that right? Who forgiveth all thy iniquities? Who healeth all thy diseases?
Yes.
That's the atonement.
Amen.
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 All your diseases are healed.
Yes.
All your sins are forgiven.
Yes.
And now another thing, who redeemeth thy life from destruction? In one translation says he redeems your life from the grave.
Yeah.
Glory be to God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Number five. Glory be to God. Everybody agree. The word of God has power to heal. And we are healed already. God is not just because you know the devil attacked your body. That's not when God started thinking about your healing. He talked about that before the foundation of the world. You are just finding out. What did he just find out? That the word of God has power to heal. Healing is in the healing power of God is in the word of God. Amen. I know some of you have prayed that you've got him, but you know the power of God is in his word.
Yeah.
He said, I am the Lord that healed thee.
Yeah.
He didn't say pray to be healed. He said, I am the Lord that healed thee.
Yes.
So what you if I come to you and you tell me, you know, I am the Lord that healed thee, what do I have to do? I just believe you.
Yes.
Amen. I don't have to pray. Look at wanting and finding out. Look at the Acts of the Apostles, particularly the Acts of the Apostles. You will find the apostles never prayed for anybody to be healed. No. They just said it.
Amen.
What did Peter and John say?
Yeah.
What did they say in Acts of the Apostles? Silver and gold have I none. Mm-hmm. But such as I have, give I thee.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus, rise up.
Wow.
See, they made it a business proposal.
Yeah.
You know what, if you read at that point, towards the end of that chapter, you will say, the disciples said to them, why are you looking at us as if it is by our own power we did it? It is faith in the name.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Faith in the name of Jesus. Glory be to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Reason number what? Number six. In fact, the Bible says he sent his word and he healed them. Amen.
Amen.
And the book of John said, and the word became flesh and dwelt amongst us. The word healed in the Old Testament, the word healed in the New Testament. Jesus was the incarnate word of God, moving and walking in the streets of Jerusalem and going from Galilee to Samaria. And every time the word of God came in contact with him, with sickness, he healed them.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Number six, we are the righteousness at the temple of God. Therefore, no sickness dwells if there's sickness in righteousness, it's been part of God is sick. Because the Bible says, what does the Bible say? In 2 Corinthians chapter 5, we have been made the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Amen. There is no sickness. So you, in the name of Jesus, as you that are the righteousness, we are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus, we should not entertain sickness in our bodies.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
All right, number what? Number seven. That's, we are the new creation. We share the same life and nature with God, the Father, and Jesus Christ, the Son. We are the same. See, the life in Him now is the life of God now. It's the same life that is in Jesus. You see, the same life that made us new creations. What did the Bible say in the book of John? John chapter 15. I am the vine, you are the branches.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
So the life in the vine is the same life in the branch. Is that right?
Amen.
Glory be to God. Amen.
Amen.
You know, one preacher, I like him. I like the way he put that. He called it the Jesus, the Christ connection.
Yeah.
Amen. He is the vine, we are the branches. We have the Christ connection.
Yeah.
So whatever is in Jesus Christ is in us.
Amen.
Amen. You know, should I say it now? Okay, let's move on. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Let's go to number 8. Praise God. Number 8. Praise God. Hallelujah. Number 8 says, alright, healing, everybody read.
Healing is the perfect will of God for us. All that Jesus did has and is for us.
Amen. All that Jesus is and has is belongs to me.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
The greatest thing you need to know about healing, one of the greatest things you need to know, or the greatest revelation you can ever have about healing, is this fact, that healing is the perfect will of God for you.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Healing is the perfect will of God for us. Amen.
Amen.
Don't ever forget that. It's the perfect will. When the devil begins to attack your mind and say, you know what you did, you know this. See, the devil is always coming in with, you know you did this, you know. Come, you know, one thing you need to tell the devil, sometimes when you start, just tell him, shut up, devil.
Yes.
Get out of here in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Healing is the perfect will of God for us.
Amen.
It's His perfect will. God is more ready to heal than we are ready to receive.
Yeah.
Amen. This is perfect will. Glory be to God. How could you have? Let me be a little lawyer here, advocate. How could God tell you to serve Him with gladness and a sickness in your body?
Mm.
And He's putting sickness. Saying, you know, I want you to serve Me with gladness. And He's putting burden of sickness. And you know,
that's ignorance.
Thank you, brother. That doesn't work.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You see that? See, so understand that fact. You know, number 9. Jesus came to destroy. We had a good time on this one last Sunday. Yeah. Jesus came to destroy the works of the devil, and the works of the devil are destroyed.
Forever.
Amen.
Amen. Forever. They are destroyed.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Never look at the devil from the standpoint of fear. Or he's going to be. Jesus, our Lord and Savior, already told us, even before Jesus went to the cross, He called Him nothing.
Mm-hmm.
He is nothing.
Amen.
In Jesus' name,
Amen.
He said, nothing shall by any means hurt you. Glory
be
to
God.
Amen.
Amen.
Number 10. This is where we are now. Praise God. You love this. Hallelujah. Praise God. Reason number 10, why you should stay well, it's very simple. Amen. Jesus came to bring us life and health and healing, not death. Jesus came to bring us life. Praise God.
Praise God.
Are you listening to me?
Yeah.
Jesus came to bring us life. Jesus came to bring us life.
Amen.
Oh, Lord Jesus, hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's go to John chapter 10, verse 10. Let's start with that. Now, while you are there, let me begin to just read something for you to do. Eternal life, when it talks about life, the word life there is Zoe, the God kind of life. It means eternal life is the life and nature of God.
Mm.
Amen. So when He came, everybody, John chapter 10, verse 9 and 10, verse, a lot of us, we have quoted this verse, but we are not taking time to assimilate it. This book of the Lord shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt what? Meditate on it day and night. Everybody read.
Listen to this. In this verse, Jesus is contrasting the ministry of the devil and his ministry. So that you will know when something is going on. You will be able to say, this is Jesus and this is the devil. So if you start to listen to what Jesus said, everybody read. The thief cometh not but for what? To steal and to kill and to destroy. That's the oppression of the devil. For eternity. That's what he does. Add that to it that he's a liar. That's what he does. He kills, so he steals, he kills, and he destroys. That which kills, that which steals, that which kills, and that which destroys is of the devil. Amen? Is that simple enough?
Yes.
That which steals, praise God. That which kills, that which destroys, is of the devil. God cannot, you know? So when you see something coming to destroy you, or coming to kill you, or coming to steal from you, you know, the devil is a thief.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He know, he steals people's health, steals people's money. Amen. Steals people's money. And then, you know, how people spend money that would have been used to do things in the kingdom of God. That will steal it by bringing sickness to people. Not only that, he steals people's joy. He's a thief. He steals people's joy. There are people who have been laying down in hospital or who have been sick for years and months. They're not joy, you know, there's no joy there. And people are saying, oh God, you know, why is God allowing this to happen? God is not, God doesn't do things like that.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Amen. Hallelujah. God, let me not knock this down right is in my heart. Amen. God don't put pollen, you know, you say the allergy season. God don't have no allergy season.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. God does not operate flu seasons.
Amen.
There's nothing like that.
Yes.
Glory be to God. Amen.
Amen.
When you see things like that, see, the devil is a thief.
Yes.
He said the thief cometh not but what to do what? To steal. Amen.
And destroy.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when he comes and tries to put any pain in your body, all you need to say, here comes the thief. Here comes the thief. I'm going to come against you. He said, listen, brothers and sisters, what do you do to a thief? A thief, you see somebody going to break your car outside, and right while he's trying to break your car, you meet him in the act, and you say, praise the Lord,
breaking some walls,
is that what you do?
No.
No, before you even before you call 911, you will slap him first.
Amen.
Is that right? You will jack
right.
him in his pants, you will jack him right there behind his pants and pull him off. And you're not going to hit his head upon your windshield.
That's right.
Is that not what you do to a thief?
Yes.
Why is it when it comes to the devil as a thief, we play cute.
Mm.
Do the same thing you do to a natural thief.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Now you're underneath there and then you try to open your door as you go to your house, you see your door is open. And somebody's sucking it. What do you do? You say, pray, oh, I'm just coming from church. Are you the thief? And you say, yeah. All right, take anything you want. You know, I'll stay outside and wait for you. Is that what you guys do to the thief?
No.
But even with your Holy Bible, even with your Holy Bible, you will first go bang. Is that right?
Yes.
Amen. And before you hold him and call 911, or you will scream. Is that what you have to do? When you see a thief, what do you do?
You,
if you are from Jamaica, I say you will scream, thief, thief, thief.
Yes.
Yes.
Is that what you do?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Why do you not, when the devil comes to steal your heart, your health, shout thief in Jesus' name.
Yes,
yes
sir.
Amen.
Yes.
He's a thief. The thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill.
You should hear Sister Smith when she gave her testimony when you can't hear.
Yeah.
You know, she just shouted, something said that something is called the Holy Ghost. He said, shout Jesus.
Yeah.
And then she shouted, Jesus.
Yeah.
Glory be to God. And when people come and say, they ask that, did you come out of this car?
Yeah.
Amen. I remember one testimony, glory be to God. I'm talking about this. One elder was told me his testimony with Sister Rose. They were traveling somewhere in Northern Nigeria. And then, you know, something happened. And the car skidded and started going. And you know, I think in that part of the country, there's a lot of valleys, and it was about to go into the valley. And right there, while the driver, they were out of control. They shouted in Jesus!
Amen.
And the thing hit and heal. That's what saved them. And they shouted Jesus, that thing hit an ant heal. And below that ant heal, there was a deep valley. Amen.
Amen.
Because, hallelujah, the antidote to everything that the devil brings against you is the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Use the name, glory be to God. Amen. Because it comes to kill.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. And then the other part of his ministry is to destroy. The devil is busy destroying churches, destroying families, destroying marriages. Are you listening to me? We should stand our ground in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen. That's what the devil does. But look at what Jesus said. Jesus said, I came. Everybody say,
I came.
I came that what, Jesus? I came that you might have life.
Yes.
I came that you might have life. And to have that life, what? More abundantly. Jesus. So point number 10, why you should stay well is that Jesus is not the author of destruction.
Amen.
He's not a thief.
Amen.
He's not. He doesn't kill.
Amen.
He doesn't destroy.
Amen.
He is. He says, I came that you might have life.
Yes.
And have it what?
Oh,
and have it more abundantly. But I like the Amplified. Are you ready for this?
Yes.
Oh Lord Jesus, hallelujah. This is good. Look at the Amplified. The Amplified says, it says, listen, the second part. It says, I came that you may have and enjoy life.
Yes.
Jesus came for his children that we might enjoy life.
Amen.
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 See, one of the things is so strange. A lot of Christians are afraid to enjoy life.
Mm.
See, they say, if you enjoy that life, you start sinning. Are you kidding? You don't have to enjoy life to sin.
Mm.
People just sin. You don't even see, you know, people say, you know, you give people license. God, you don't need people. You don't give people license to sin. They just sin.
Amen.
They have a sin nature.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. Amen. Yes. Listen to this. This is very interesting. Listen to this. It says, but I came, right, Jesus? Jesus said, but I came that they might have life, that they might have and enjoy it. Enjoy life.
Amen.
That's right. Amen. And enjoy life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Enjoy life and have it in abundance. Not just have life and enjoy it, but have it in abundance to the full,
yes,
till it overflows.
Amen.
God called us to an overflowing life.
Amen.
Overflowing in our health.
Amen.
Our health should be so full of life.
Amen.
Our health, we stay healthy.
Amen.
Amen. We don't even know when allergy season comes.
Yes,
we don't know, glory be to God, when flu season comes. Because we are so full of his life.
Amen.
His life, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Is overwhelming us.
Amen.
You know, now I can say what, you know, I had a release to say. You know, there's a back, I think it's Romans chapter 8. He says, if you live after the lust, you know, they talk about the spirit, the flesh lusted after the flesh, and the flesh lust after the spirit. You know, I was looking at it, you know, something came into my spirit. Well, immediately, a lot of us seek that in the Bible. We are always talking about, you know, sin, lust, sin, you know, look woman, but it's more than that. You know what? This flesh lost to it lost to stay in pain. Yeah, that's right. This flesh craves pain. When the flesh has pain, that's what it likes to do. Because of pity party. It craves to be sick. See, most people have not seen it like that. You know, when immediately we hear the word, you know,
that word lost in that verse, we immediately were thinking about, you know, immorality, you know, drunkenness, this. The same thing. This body craves pain. It craves to lay down and just do nothing. Why? Because this body craves to die. Amen.
Amen.
But he says, if you live in the realm of the spirit, you will deal with the craving. Hallelujah, of the flesh.
Yes, sir.
This flesh that craves to be sick, we crave to be healed.
Amen.
This flesh that craves to die, we crave for life. Amen. Hallelujah. You listen to me.
Yes, sir.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Because he came that we might have life.
Yes.
Have life abundantly till it overflows. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Because this life, because there is corruption in this body. But thank God we have the Holy Ghost.
Yes, sir.
Thank God the Spirit of life is in us. Amen.
Amen.
The Spirit that raised up Jesus Christ from the dead is in love. It's in us. And therefore it is pumping life into our bodies. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh Lord Jesus. Listen to this. He came that we might have life. Mm-hmm. Have it to the full till it overflows.
Yeah.
See? God's children, listen to this. We have the spirit of life in us.
Yes.
We used to sing a song in those days. If the same spirit that raised up Christ from the dead dwell in you, that same spirit will quicken your mortal bodies. Then we have another song we used to sing. I've got this, I found a new way of living. I found a new life divine. I've got the fruits of the spirit. I've got love, joy, peace, goodness, kindness. I've got prosperity, power, and victory. I'm abiding in the vine. Is that right?
Yes.
Amen. You are abiding in the vine. Hallelujah. And another thing is this. One of the things that have happened to Christians is that they look at life from this standpoint of the flesh. No, we are spirit beings.
Amen.
Everything we do should be led by the Spirit.
Amen.
I mean, I'm not talking, a lot of Christians, when they hear led by the Spirit, they are thinking, you know, because a lot of people are spooky in church. You know, they like to do weird things.
Yeah.
Being spiritual has nothing to do with weirdness.
Mm.
It's just you are aligning yourself with who God made you.
Yes.
God is a spirit.
Yeah.
And the Bible says that they that worship him in spirit.
Yeah.
And in truth.
Yes.
In truth.
Yes.
He created us in his image and likeness.
Yeah.
We are like him.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Praise God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. We are like him. Listen, eternal life. See, the Bible said Jesus came that we might have life. I have to stress this point number 10. Because a lot of God's children are not living a life.
Amen.
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 A lot of God's children are not enjoying life.
Amen.
He's the author of life. He lives. We have life. We are so full of life. That is it's an absurdity that our life is so dry. It's not productive.
Yeah.
There's no joy.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh my goodness. Listen to me. Life should flow through us.
Amen.
Amen.
And I gave you my definition of prosperity. It's the life of God that saved me, that is in my spirit.
Yeah.
If the same thing happens, it affects everything around me.
Yes, sir.
It produces life, hallelujah.
Amen.
It produces money, glory be to God. It produces prosperity.
Amen.
It produces strength, hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That people will look at us. Can you imagine when the people look at Jews in the Old Testament, the Israelites? They saw a different race of people.
Yeah.
Well, you say those are the Jews. But what does the Bible say in the book of Peter? It says we are a different race of people.
Yes.
We are a royal priesthood. We are a holy nation.
Yes.
We are, and then it says we are peculiar.
Yeah.
Check the word peculiar in the dictionary. Amen. It means there's nobody like us. God has made us peculiar. Because Christians, born again children of God, we have the same spirit of God in us. Hallelujah. We can do what the natural world cannot do. We can be what the natural human being cannot be. Are you listening to me? Hallelujah, we can live. Glory be to God. The number of your days, he said he will fulfill. God is the author of life. And God's children should be living in life. Hallelujah. Not living in fear. Oh, you know, if I go out now, something will happen. That's the devil already.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's read point number 10. Jesus came to bring us life. Jesus is not the author of destruction. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus came to bring us life. We have life. Glory be to God.
Amen.
The day you accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, that day the life of God came inside of you.
Amen.
Amen. Impossibilities became possible. If you can believe. That's why Jesus said all things are possible to him that believe. Paul put it in the church age. He's put it like this. I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens me.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh man, we have lost that idea. We're going to have more. See, when we live like this, as children of God, I have his life. That should be my prayer. Oh God, I want to thank you. Your life abides in me. Oh God, hallelujah. But let's just lift up our hands and thank you. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you. That you have this life. Hallelujah. That this life is in you. Hallelujah. The life of God. Hallelujah. The life in you now is a different life. Hallelujah. I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me. Gave himself for me. Hallelujah. I have the life of God in me. It is no longer I that liveth, but Christ lives in me. For the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith of the Son of God who gave himself for me and gave himself for me.
Amen.
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 Now let me ask you one question and I'm wrapping up.
Thank you, Jesus.
If that life of God, it is no longer I that lives, but Christ lives in me.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Everybody say amen to that?
Amen.
Can you show me in the Bible, from Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, where Jesus Christ had headache? Where Jesus Christ had stomach ache? Mm-hmm. Oh, you know, he came and said, you know, Peter, I feel sick today, I don't feel like going out.
No.
Did you find that?
No.
Is that in the Bible?
No.
So what do you think, what gives you the right that you, tell me what gives you the right to think that you now can have any of those ailments and Jesus is living in you? And Jesus said, the Bible says it is no longer I that lives, but Christ, the anointed one, and his anointing lives in us.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
He's the author of life. He came that we might have life and have it more abundantly. Glory be to God. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Praise. I announce to you in the name of Jesus. You have no right to be sick in this church.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Just you have no right to be poor. You have no right to be broke. You have no right to be depressed. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We say like Jesus.
Amen.
The prince of this world cometh and findeth nothing of his in me. The prince of this world cometh. That's how we should talk. The devil comes and sees nothing that belongs to him in us. No fear. No pain, no sickness, no depression, no lack. Glory be to God in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Why? Because we are God's children.
Amen.
Yes. Hallelujah. When let's stand on our feet, praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Glory be to God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God. Yes. The name of Jesus is above every name.
Yes.
At the name of Jesus, every knee bow.
Yes.
That Jesus, that name, that Jesus is our Lord and Savior. The name belongs to us, to you.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. The name of Jesus belongs to us, to you. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. You should be able at this time, if there is sickness in your body, when pain comes, even if it is in the night, don't say, you know, I have to wait in the morning, you know, I have to wait in the morning to, you know, to call the doctor. If you wake up in the night and, you know, and you have to use the bathroom or something, wakes you up, just right there on the bed, say in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
devil, get out of here. It's bedtime. Get out in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
amen.
Amen.
devil, the devil doesn't wait.
That's right.
I mean, you know, something you tell you. The devil comes to you and say, I'm about to put this sickness in the devil.